Okay, first of all, last time some of y'all are asking about that extension cord that my uncle made for 220 to 220 plug. And I don't know what kind of wire it is. It's kind of thick and it's real hard to roll. But I don't know if it's safe or not, but it seems to work pretty good. I'll use it. And this is the Weldmax multi-process. That's the one that does the plasma cutting, stick welding, and TIG welding with a foot pedal. And I could use that little lunchbox one, but it's hooked up for 110 right now, and I don't want to switch out the plug. I was just playing around with it just to test it. It seems to work pretty good. And the reason I have it all busted out right now is because someone wants me to put a little plate on their trailer so they can put a little winch because the one that comes with it was all broken. And so this is the one they bought, and it's just a friend that I'm doing it for. And I was going to show you all why. Talk about beveling. This is what this video is about, beveling. I know some people will talk about it, but in case you don't know what it is, I'm going to fit up this little piece of pipe to that flat plate right there. And if I don't bevel it, then it wouldn't be as strong of a weld. I'm going to put it right in there. And I don't know what those little plates are. He bought them from the store. They're like $14 for that. That's what you, but it's see, I'm gonna grind off the edges so it fits inside of there, and then I'm gonna put a little bevel on there to show you what I'm talking about. And what I'm gonna use this little grinder from harborfreight, the 8-inch grinder, and it's real weak. Like it seems like it goes slower than the little 4.5-inch grinder, the one that you hold in your hand. I don't know. It just seems a lot slower. But anyway, so, oh damn, this is it finished. I should have put that at the end of the video. Oh, look, I got some tomatoes. This is Super Sweet 100. I'm pruning them too, so they're gonna be good. Okay, so this is what I'm talking about, beveling. It's when you grind the edge so there's like a groove so you can stick your welding rod in there so that it melts it all completely. And if you want a little gap between the pipe and the plate there so that it can really get penetration, you get a little piece of welding rod like that so that there can be a little space in there. Then when you weld, you stick your stick in that groove where there's a gap, and then you make it so that it just melts it completely. That's what a bevel's for, so that it melts the bottom and that pipe piece completely together. And you, once you, if you get it right, when you hit when the stick's in there, you hear like a sound that like a where the it's making a little hole and just piercing to the other side. You can see kind of sparks coming through the middle of the pipe if you're doing it right. I'm beveling also that piece. First, I ground it so it'll fit. Then I beveled it so that I can stick my stick welder, my stick rod in that groove, you know, and make it so that it really penetrates, like goes through the back a little bit. That's what beveling is, like when people talk about beveling. And if you do that right, you can use a real weak welder and just do a bunch of groove, like a groove like that, and keep pa doing passes and passes so that it's good. Okay. This is like with all the slagging. I put it all together. I couldn't really videotape me welding because I didn't really have enough time. Because, oh, I got a little trick too that I gotta tell you all about. I'll tell you after this. Look, this is my dog. He's doing good.
Who is that?
He can't jump up on stuff, but he runs around and
Come on, Scrappy. Up.
does stuff like
Come on.
that.
Come on.
The trick that I was talking about is if you, like you're doing welding for someone.
Oh, puppy.
And you don't want to charge them like
Can't get
family
up.
or friends,
Come on.
is to
Come on, jump.
have them get you something
Oh,
like a bandsaw blade or
dog.
you know, something like that.
Poor little dog.
Like, say you need it for that job,
One more
and then
time.
you can collect on your tools that way. Say, oh, yeah, I need some more sticks to do it. Even if you have some, you can just tell them to pick them up, and they'll be like, oh, okay. They'll still be grateful.
Come on.